So, jetzt ist es soweit. Mein persönlicher Headliner sitzt jetzt neben mir, Dave Grohl von Foo Fighters. So it's a really big pleasure, a great pleasure to have you here today.
Thank you.
So, yeah, I prepared something for you.
We've
got, like, an award for you.
Really?
A video award, a special one.
Really?
Viva 2 to Rock Tanya, Viva, a video award. We've got different nominations.
Uh-huh.
Like, first one is the milk container. Do you know that of Blur's video, Coffee and TV? Which is walking
around? Oh, yeah, 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 I saw that, yeah, yeah.
Then your new video, Breakout, which is fabulous, and then also the crew of Fatboy Slim thing praise you. Do you remember that?
Which video was that?
So funny, where the dancing crew is.
Oh, yeah, 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 Spike Jonze, yeah, that's good.
And the fourth is Beastie Boys, Sabotage.
That's right.
And we've decided you to get an award from us, yeah. So, that's for you.
Thank you so much. This is such an honor.
You have to hold a speech.
I'm really, really happy. I want to thank Gus, Brant, for helping us come up with the idea for the video. And then I want to thank Jimmy Swanson for helping us come up with the idea for the video. And I want to thank, this one's for the band, man. Thank you.
You're a really great actor. So.
No, actually
yes,
I'm not.
Yes, you are.
Well.
Well, the last one.
Thanks. No, thank you. Oh, the thing came on. Sorry, here, I'll just wear that on my chest right there.
Wonderful, best video superstar.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
Are there any plans in acting?
Not really, no.
Not really.
Just because when we make videos, we have a 4-minute time window to make a little short story or short film, whatever. It's easy in videos to act because you don't have to speak. You know, there's no, it's not really acting. It's more like a silent movie.
But that would be funny to have a longer silent movie, because always when new videos of Foo Fighters come in, it's a
That's
big party,
true.
You know, our channel.
Well, what we're talking about doing now is, well, we want to release a home video that has the story of the band, but we kind of play ourselves and act out the story of the band from the first rehearsal to, you know, the touring in the van and then playing in festivals and so it could be really funny. It's either do that or we just cast the entire movie would be midgets because everybody thinks midgets are so funny. So we might do that. But no, I don't think anyone's really gonna do any movie acting anytime soon.
But if you would do anything, then it would be just comedian or could you?
I don't know. You know, I would actually rather be a stand-up comedian than an actor. Because acting is really, I don't think acting is such a noble profession. Shakespearean actors, yes, I'm sure there's a lot of people that are amazing and can project emotion and take on, you know, personality after personality. But for the most part, I think that that acting is kind of weird. I think that acting as a profession, you get paid to be someone else all the time. And I just think it's weird.
Not you, so if you do something comedian-like, it's from you. It's
well, like, I'd rather go out and tell stories to people than act as whatever, like a cop in some stupid mafia movie. It just wouldn't work.
Okay. So, dass Dave Grohl ein wunderbarer, großartiger Schauspieler ist, haben wir ja schon gesehen in den letzten Videos, die da rauskamen, unter anderem auch Breakout. Er hat aber jetzt nicht vor, irgendwie Schauspieler zu werden, was vielleicht recht schade ist, aber für ihn ist Schauspieler auch Schauspielerei nicht so die Megakunst. Er macht lieber Musik. Und ich würde sagen, von ihm gibt es jetzt was zu hören, nämlich Foo Fighters Live für euch. Und weiter geht's hier mit Dave Grohl von Foo Fighters. So yesterday I met Muse and they are a really big fan of you and I should greet you from them.
From
so,
whom?
Muse.
Oh, Muse, yeah. We toured with them in America with the Red Hot Chili Peppers.
They're really stressed at present. I mean, they're just about 1.5 years, they're touring around and stuff like that. So you don't do that any further in that way, like newcomers do often?
Well, we've at this point we've been touring for almost a year. So we're close. Well, we're a little stressed just because when we released our first record in 1995 and we toured for a year and a half. And then we went and made the second record. We didn't really take a break. We just stopped touring, made the record, toured for another year and a half. So that's like 3 years. And then at the end of that tour, we said, okay, let's stop and build a studio, take some time to relax. And we always promise ourselves that we're never going to tour that much again. That's too much. A year and a half is too much. Next time it won't be like that.
Do you have,
but then it always is like a year and a half. So,
so do you have other priorities besides the music?
Oh yeah.
And what comes first?
Well, there's a lot of personal priorities, but you know, your biggest priority should be your well-being, your state of mind, you know. Stress is bad. Nobody deserves stress. Sometimes you have to stress because you have to work in order to get things done. But I think that anything to eliminate stress from your life, you should, because you only live so long. You have a short life here. You should enjoy it while you can. You have responsibilities and you have obligations, but you have to kind of like draw the line somewhere. So honestly, I think the biggest priority is just keeping yourself happy, you know?
And is there anything special what you do when you need a break, when you think, so now it's enough?
We just say no.
We just say no.
We just basically say, hey,
go home.
We're tired. I mean, we usually work hard enough so we get to the point where we say, hey, we're really tired, and people will understand. They'll say, okay, we'll give you a break. That's
so
fine.
Is there anything going on in the future with the Foo Fighters, anything special?
Well, we're gonna record some more soon, I think. I'm doing a side project called Probot with a bunch of heavy metal singers, old school metal people that when I grew up listening to underground metal, I had favorite bands like Merciful Fate and Trouble and Voivod and stuff like that. And so I started recording all of this heavy music stuff, and I'm gonna have a different singer sing on a different song each. One singer for every song. And so I'm working on that. And you know, things like that.
So in der Zukunft werden wir von Dave Grohl noch einiges hören. Er macht jetzt auch Nebenprojekte im Heavy-Metal-Bereich. Mit den Touren, da will er sich jetzt nicht ganz so überlassen, weil wir haben nämlich zuvor gesprochen von Muse, die ich gestern getroffen habe und die auch riesen Foo Fighters-Fans sind, die sich vielleicht so ein bisschen übernehmen mit dem ganzen Touren, aber das will Dave Grohl jetzt auf alle Fälle nicht machen. Er lässt es sich jetzt vielleicht ein bisschen gut gehen und tourt jetzt mal nicht so viel. Im Endeffekt ist es ja dann eh wieder der gleiche Stress, der rauskommt, aber er versucht es doch relativ zu reduzieren und ich würde mal sagen, jetzt gibt es noch ein Bit von Foo Fighters Live.